Hey, this is Andre from AndreElvon.com. And hey, today we are going to do a very quick tutorial on the Facebook Ads Manager. The Facebook Ads Manager is pretty much a dashboard where all of your ads are stored, where you can edit your ads. You can actually create ads within Facebook Ads Manager. And I actually wrote a blog post about it, and you could click on the blog post somewhere down in the description. You should find a link somewhere on the description or somewhere on the screen. So to go into it real quick, I'm going to show you a couple of things. Actually, in order to find the Facebook Ads Manager, you can go to your business page. You see my business page right here. If you scroll, I'm going to point out a couple of things as I scroll down. Also, the sign up button there, where you can actually promote your sign up button. You can promote your website, your page for likes. You see the promote website button down there. And right here, this is going to be real quick. When I hover my mouse over the promote button down here, the lower left hand corner, as we should say, you see this crazy looking guy right here. That's me. See where it says Ads Manager? You can actually click on that, but you have to be real quick, otherwise you'll get this here. And here's where you can also, like I said, promote your sign up button, your website, promote your page as well. So on your home screen, your home page of your business page or your fan page, whichever you like to call it, there's multiple ways to create ads. But I'm gonna go into the Facebook Ads Manager. Hey, another thing with the Facebook Ads Manager, if by any chance you click on this here and it goes too fast and you can't click that, you can either go about it two ways. You can actually go to Google. You can Google Facebook Ads Manager. Just make sure that you're logged in your Facebook account and they'll lead you to it. Also, you could, let's see, there's another way of doing it also. Click that button down here, or you can Google it. There's another way I was gonna lead you to it. Oh, actually, the other way I was going to say you can go to facebook.com/ads/manager, and you'll see the Facebook Ad Manager. Should bring up your account and just click on it and get into the Facebook Ads Manager that way as well. Okay, I'm in the Facebook Ads Manager, or at least my Facebook Ads Manager, and there's a lot of information right here, as you can see. In my blog post, I spoke about all of these different buttons and the different purposes for them. But the one thing on this page here that I want to show you is the create campaign buttons. There's two of them. There's one right here to the left, and there's one in the upper right hand corner here, the create ad, and they serve the same purpose. Whenever you create ads, you can see how they stack up right here, and you can scroll down and see more of my ads, but I'm not gonna do that. I'm actually gonna click on the create campaign button right here, so you can see the ad set. It'll show you. See the different ad sets. What this is, this first part here that I'm going to go through, is like I said before on the previous page, there's a lot of information. There's a lot of information right here. But this page here, you can create a new audience. So a new audience that you like to target, for my sake, or if you've already used Facebook ads, you can see the different, it'll auto save your previous audience. So I'm not going to spend too much time on that. I'm going to scroll down a little bit. Make sure you put in the different locations. You can target the age, target the gender. Basically, what I normally do is I'll go to the insights tab on my business page, and you can there's a place where you can find who's visiting your page and kind of see your target audience that way. And if you have a website, which I highly recommend, you can actually go into your Google Analytics and see your target audience, see who's been visiting your site as well. Let me move that off. That thing is jumping a little bit. So I'm going to scroll down a little bit here. Make sure you enter a language, your interest. So here, what you want to do is you want to make sure that you enter something like my sake. If I want to target bankers, if I want to target whatever profession that you want to target or type of people, or if you want to target a page, you can enter that into that box right here as well. All right, I want to show you this, and this is very important here. You see the placements? These are actually where you want your ad to show. What sticks out to me is Instagram. So make sure that you connect your Instagram page with your Facebook page, and there's a way to do that. You probably can Google that process. I ought to make a video about that. So I should make a video about how you can connect your Instagram account. So that's something that I may do. Also, you can see right here. See, it tells you the daily reach, and on Facebook and a daily reach for Instagram. And also that depends on your daily budget. So I usually keep it $1 or $2, depending on what ad that I'm running, $1 or $2. And mainly what I've been doing lately is testing. So I've been running like $1 a day or $2 a day. And you can really, really get some engagement on Facebook. Another thing that I want to talk about as well, be sure, and I speak about this in the blog post, make sure that you split test. If you're starting out and you don't have a saved audience, make sure that you split test. Just run two ads and make sure you keep your budget low. I believe Facebook requires you to at least run $1 a day. So you might, let's say if one of your ads, you had a video and the other one was text-based. So, and you know, whatever little tweaks you want to make in those ads, just make sure you do that so you can see which one performs the best. One of the things that I want to speak of real quick is these columns here. You see the results is the engagements, the likes, shares, comments is what this is. The thing that sticks out to me, look at the video views. This is a great indicator in where the content is going on Facebook. Video is huge, and it's going to get better. And before you know it, I believe in a couple of years, the majority of the content that you're going to see will be video based on Facebook. And Facebook is, as you see here, they're giving you a pretty good deal on per video. This campaign I paid under 1 cent, so 0.2 cents, if I'm saying that right. As you can see, just look at the video views here. Video views right here. They perform far better than some of your other campaigns. Video is huge. Video is huge. It's only gonna get better on not only on Facebook, but all the other platforms, especially the platforms where the video is auto-playing, places such as Facebook and Twitter and Instagram. So video is already huge, but it's going to be bigger in the years to come. Hey, download my free ebook, The 13 Online Marketing Tools That Local Businesses Can Utilize Today. I give that away for free. And you can find the link somewhere on this video. And of course, make sure you subscribe to my YouTube channel. You should find that somewhere. Go to my YouTube homepage. If you don't see a link somewhere on the screen or somewhere down below, to subscribe to my channel for any of my upcoming videos. And of course, thanks for spending time with me. Thanks for watching. And I hope to see you in the near future. And hey, make sure you like, share, comment this video. Thanks for watching once again. I appreciate it. Thank you.